Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the channel. Hope you've been doing well. Hope you've been doing great. Today we're talking about the MetaThread Supply Duffel Backpack. Yeah, that's right. You heard it from me, okay? It's a duffel and it's a backpack. I'm going to explain to you why it's both and why it's amazing, absolutely amazing that it's both, okay? It does have a lot of similar features, just like the Level 3 pack from MetaThreads that I am always ranting and raving about that I absolutely adore. And it does have stuff like ballistic gray nylon. It does have YKK weather guarded zippers, laptop compartment, pass-through cable management to where you can run a USB charger. It has multiple modular compartments to design and configure however you want, among other compartments that are specifically designed for certain peripherals and certain accessories that you need to take with you when you're traveling on the go, or whatever, you're just going over to a buddy's house to have a LAN party, okay? We will get more into this as we go on, but those are the main key features. This bag is carry-on friendly, so whenever things start opening up and we start flying around, this is going to be the bag that you want to be flying with, because this is going to house everything that you have on it. Coming in at a solid 9.5 inches by 13.5 inches by 22 inches. That is the perfect size to where you can literally just grab it, throw it in your overhead bin, and you are good to go. Getting right into it, you might be asking yourself, why are you talking about backpack and duffel? Okay, because it's both. Traditionally on a duffel, you have a shoulder strap and then you have two grab handle straps. This one's different, however. You do have your traditional shoulder strap, as you see here, padded, nice and comfortable, has detached rings where you can just, you know, unhook them and then stow this away if you need to. You have two straps that go this way. You do have quick disconnect, as you can see right here, to where it just comes right off and snaps right back in. That's how you get the backpack straps on and off. On the bottom here, you do have two D-rings to where you're hooking these up on the bottom for those straps. So let's say if you don't want to rock those, you just take them right off. You do have an adjustable sternum scratch vertically and horizontally to where you can get it just right on your chest, and then you can cinch it down if you got a pretty heavy payload for if you're traveling. Let's say if your shoulder's just killing you, because let's be honest, scientifically proven, it is not good to have your shoulder strap on one shoulder like that. It's just not ergonomically friendly. So the fact that they've made a travel bag that can be turned into a backpack is very ergonomical, is very, very good on your back, and you're able to adjust the straps to where you need it, to where it's hugging nice and tight onto your back, and the weight distribution is just solid, okay? For sake of this video, we're gonna take these off so I can get you into some of the other features of this bag. Setting these aside, I'll show you later on where I house those straps whenever I'm not using them. Haven't been traveling lately, so I've been using this a lot as a gym bag, or if I need to take a bunch of stuff, whether it's filming gear or anything, I use this bag as an accessory bag, if that makes sense. Some of the features on this bag is it is a 40 liter bag whenever it is sitting just stout like this, okay? It does have the option to where you can extend it out to 60 liters of a heavy payload to where you can fit what you need to go where you need to go. And we'll get into that a little bit later. First, I wanna talk about these side accessory pouches. One of them is specific, as you can see right here. You might be looking at this one wondering, okay, well, it's something standard, no big deal. But on this one, this is where your pass-through is for your charger, okay? Now, the size of this bad boy, if you can see the size of this, you can fit any size portable charger, battery bank, the big ones that can power your laptop. You can fit it in here. And on the side right here, if you look at the top-down view, you can see that that's where the pass-through is. So you put it in here, cinch it down with Velcro, that way it's not bouncing all around unless you have one of those massive ones, and you just plop it in here, zip this bad boy shut. Let's say if you're carrying this, okay, what's gonna happen is this pass-through is gonna be on your backpack style, this is gonna be on your bottom left. So you're gonna be able to access that pass-through from your bottom left, and you're gonna be able to plug your phone in, just like on the Level 3 pack from MetaThreads, and you're going to be able to charge your phone on the go, or your accessory or device, whatever it may be. The rest of the pouches are just simple open style. You can use these for whatever you need to. They're not designated for anything specific other than that one. You do have MOLLE webbing on both of them on the side, a little bit on the bottom here, full across on the top here. You have two rows and one row, and then you do have the Velcro hook and loop stitching right here to where you can slap your favorite patch. Me personally, I usually put patches that are one style on this side and one style on the other side because it helps me distinguish what I have on each side of the bag. Helps me kind of like just remember like, oh, that patch means that that's where like, let's say my toiletry kit goes. On the other side, same thing, just another molly webbing style patch. You have another hook loop right here with another molly webbing right below it. Same thing, you just open them up. There's nothing special about them other than the fact that they are what you want to make out of it. That's the special part about it, is that whatever you design to fit inside here, it's gonna fit just fine and you're gonna be able to fit anything you need inside there. Other features of this, the external part of the bag, is you have seatbelt style nylon on the side that is a grab handle to where you can pick it up and set it down. You don't have the two straps of the elephant ear styles like I was talking about before, but you do have the two grab handles, which is even better. So basically what that means is this is like a load bearing style bag that you have a lot of gear in. You're able to lift it kind of close to your body and use that upper back support to where you can use your shoulders and everything to put this in your overhead container or anything. Or maybe if you have it kind of shoved down, you can slide this under your seat. But for sake of it, I would just throw this in the overhead, throw this in a back seat, throw this in a trunk, whichever way you're going, and you'll be good to go. On the north side of the bag, this is gonna be the part that is up right behind your head if you're wearing it backpack style, or front or back if you're wearing it duffel style, it doesn't matter. This is where you're gonna be housing your headphones. You have a little elastic strap here that you can stretch around whatever headset you're putting in here, and then you can fit a wide variety of headsets. Now, I'll be honest, my favorite choice of headset is gonna be the Astro headsets, whether it's the A40 or the A50, specifically the A40s. They've been my diehard headset for I don't know how many years, and they're my go-to for everything. They fit in here just perfect. And you know how the top of those A40s are nice and big. This just loops all the way around, nice and stretchy, and just seats them ever so slightly in there. And you still have plenty of room. There's nothing. And on the outside, you have a little bit of padding, so nothing on the exterior is gonna smack into them and break them or anything like that. So just like I said, these are YKK guarded zippers as well. This is gonna keep everything weather guarded to where rain hits you, it beads off. That is the beauty of the YKK weather guarded zippers. And then the ballistic grade nylon, it will not soak through, it just beads right off. And you're just on your merry way doing whatever you need to do. On the other side of the bag, you do have the extended portion of it to where you can use this as one, you can go inward, whether you have dirty clothes or whether you have shoes. Me specifically, I've been using this as my gym bag, so I've been throwing my workout shoes in here. So whenever I get off work, I can take my steel toe shoes off and I can take my workout shoes off and do that. That's what I've been using this for. If I was traveling, however, this is more than likely, if I didn't have access to a washer or dryer and I had to fly home the next day or whatever, I would throw all my dirty clothes in a bag in here. That way it's separated from everything else, because you don't want your stinky stuff stinking up your nice, fresh, new clothes that you just got, or maybe your next day's out for anything. So that separation is what I've learned over the years to have in a bag. And the fact that this one has it, I like it. You can extend it out though. You can extend it out, giving you an extra 20 liters. That is massive, okay? You're turning this bag from a 40 liter bag into a 60 liter bag. That is phenomenal. The fact that you have that, and the fact is that whenever it extends out, this is what's gonna be on the tail end of your body. Because if you're wearing it as a backpack, it's gonna be coming down like that. However, the only thing I wasn't too fond of at first was the fact that you have this, doesn't have a way to be tucked into anything. Okay, you just basically, you set this down, you expand your bag. But the good thing about that is you do have a durable grab handle that's not gonna fray or rip over time. You do have ballistic grade nylon that's gonna withstand the abuse that you're putting it into. So the fact that this does not tuck away, it's not that big of a deal considering the fact of the material it's made out of. If it was made of something softer or less durable, I'd be extremely worried. But for the price point of this bag at $149.95, the features that you're getting are mind-blowing. The fact is there's so much that you can do with this bag. You can make it work for however you need to, okay? Keeping it on the external part of the bag, there's one last feature that I wanna get into before we dive into the inside, which is a whole nother plethora of things that you can do for it. On the outside right here, you have a giant, giant pass-through for a laptop. Look at that. Look at the size of that. The size comparison of this is just insane. And the cool thing about it, and find that other zipper, is this completely passed through. So meaning the fact is that whichever way you put your laptop in here, you're gonna be able to access it from both sides. It's not like you're gonna have to, let me flip it around. No, not like that. This one's gonna keep you solid. It's gonna keep you doing whatever you need. The padding on this, on the bottom right here, if you can see that, it's just a solid piece of padding on the bottom to protect you whenever you set it down hard and you're worried about maybe something getting damaged. You're gonna be solid, you're gonna be golden. Don't be throwing it around, of course. If you have a gaming laptop, I'm sure you're gonna be taking care of it. So, but the fact that there's padding on the bottom and on the top is very comforting to know that you have that. On the bottom here, still weather-guarded YKK zippers, still ballistic-grade nylon on the back. You do have two supporting straps going across for the load-bearing, and then you do have a nice reflective Meta logo coming down the side. Just give it that little bit of spice, or, you know, it's just the right amount of branding. It's nothing like crazy, like neon colors, like, oh, this is what I'm... Nah, it's very stealth-like. That's what I like. So, getting into the top of the bag, once again, the zippers all the way around, YKK weather-guarded zippers, ballistic-grade nylon, everywhere on the external side of the bag, even on the extension part whenever you pull it out. Flipping this bad boy up, my OCD is very calm right now, knowing the fact that if I have many cables that need to go in with me on a trip, they're gonna be organized very, very well. The fact of how many pass-throughs are webbed in and out of this bad boy right here, you're gonna be solid. Whether it's charging cables, controller cables, you know, like USB extender cables, whether it's your headset cables, if it's your mic cable, if it's your power adapter, if it's anything, anything can fit up on top of here. That is the beauty of it. Tucking this in a little bit because I wanna show you this bottom piece right here. Earlier I had said whenever I have those backpack straps, I don't really use them whenever I'm on my everyday stuff. This is more for whenever I start traveling again. This is really gonna save my butt. Just the fact that I can plop it on as a backpack and be good to go. I usually tuck mine in right here just so I always know where they're at. I use most of the external features right now for my everyday stuff, for my gym life. And the inside kind of just is my hovering section for like extra clothes if I need to. So I just tuck those in here. If you look right here, you do have a spot to where you can put a keyboard. This is more for a tournament style keyboard, not a full style standard size keyboard. It's more for the smaller competitive ones. But the beauty of this is they left it open on the sides to where you can fit whatever size you feel comfortable fitting in here. So you can fit roughly, I would say maybe a 17 or 18 inch length keyboard and then traditional style without the wrist support on it. But it is padded and it is felt lined on the inside of it, so you know your keyboard's not gonna get all jacked up or scratched or rubbed off on the numbers or the letters or anything like that. And it does have a Velcro hookup right there to where it keeps everything solid and sound. Flipping it around to the other side, you do have a spot for your controllers, okay? So you have it to where you can put your mouse or you can put your, let's say, your favorite SCUF controller, Xbox Elite controller, whether it's just a regular PlayStation or Xbox controller or anything. You can throw that in here. You could technically shove two in here, but they're gonna be super close together. But let's say if you and your sibling are going on a trip and you wanna kinda carry his stuff or her stuff, that way that you can help them out and not have so much weight on them. You can stuff two in here. You can use this one as well if you're not taking a mouse. But for people that travel with both a mouse and a controller, that we got you covered on this one. It's gonna be able to fit right in here and each one's gonna be labeled to where you can just peek in and boom, you're good to go. The labeling and everything on this bag, I do like. It's something about the cleanliness of it that I get like, I don't know, I get excited about, man. It's little small details like that that really mean a lot. Nonetheless, that's gonna be the inside of the bag. The whole bag through and through is just jam-packed with features. It's just like the Level 3 pack in many, many ways. That thing I love and adore. I love telling people about that bag the first time that I meet somebody at the event that has never even seen the bag, that has no clue what about it. And then just seeing their sense of shock when I say all of the features and everything, it blows them away. And it feels good to know that I'm with a company that provides that level of modularity for customers. Whether you're a paintball content creator, or if you're a gamer or a streamer or on the go editing or anything like that, that bag would cover you. This is the same way. Yes, it does have spots where it's keyboard, controllers, cable management. it doesn't necessarily mean that you're bound to that. It doesn't mean that, oh, I can only put a controller in there. No, you can put whatever you want in there. I actually have a buddy that doesn't like traveling with a keyboard, but he likes using the keyboard on his computer, and he was even telling me that his mixing board would fit perfect in there. There you go. It's just there's so many options when it comes to this duffel, whether you want it for your lifestyle, whether you want it for gym, whether you want it for traveling, going to events, going to LAN parties, going to competitions to perform. It allows you to do that. So that is going to be the MetaThreads Supply Duffel Backpack. I know it sounds weird saying it, but the fact that it's a duffel and a backpack is just solid, okay? There's so many options on here. There's so many ways you can go about this. If you would like to purchase this bag, the link would be down in the description below. It is $149.95 US dollars currently right now. And if you would love to save yourself some money, you can use Project K at checkout. It'll save you 10% off the bag. Helps me, helps you. Everything will be listed in the description below. And yeah, hopefully all this clears up so I can start seeing y'all at events, because I want to show the world this bag. I want to show everybody at all the PAX and the TwitchCon, everything. I want to show them this bag because this thing is phenomenal. Like, I thought the level 3 pack was good. This thing blows that out of the water, and that is still blowing many, many, many bags out of the water. So anyways, that's going to be it. Thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you for the love and support. I appreciate every single one of you, and I hope you guys have a fantastic day, all right? Peace.